Dear students, I am Nandana NG, Assistant Professor, Department of English, GFGC, Bagepalli, which is affiliated to Bengaluru North University. Today, I'll be presenting the lesson titled How Kacha Got the Secret Prescribed for the 4th Semester BCom, authored by Thangam Krishnan. Always, I make it a point in the class to read or gather information about the author, so that we'll try to see what is it that the author is trying to reflect in his works. The lesson titled How Kacha Got the Secret is written by Thangam Krishnan. Born in 1949, Thangam Krishnan has more than 25 years of experience in marketing. This seems unlikely of a literary writer, but then Thangam Krishnan, in spite of his association with marketing, yet he retained his affinity or love for literature, which can be seen in his works. How Kacha Got the Secret is one of his very famous short stories. Mythology, Athava Pauranika. The moment I say mythology or Pauranika, images of gods and demons engaged in fierce battle come to our mind. I am sure it is all related to the innumerable stories we have heard in our childhood. There is another milestone in mythology, that is namely the churning of the ocean of milk, or as it is known in the vernacular as Sagara Manthana. At the end of the Sagar Manthan, what came out was Amrut, or the elixir of eternal life, which was consumed by the gods and hence they became immortal. But before all these happened, the gods and demons were engaged in a severe war. There were a lot of casualties on both the sides, but still, in a surprising manner, the number of demons kept increasing steadily. If gods were dying by the dozens, the demons were dying by hundreds, but yet, the very next day, the same number of demons were seen on the battlefield. Now, this puzzled the gods. Brihaspati was the teacher of gods. He had a handsome son by the name Kacha. Kacha observed that the demons were coming back to life, and he questioned his father regarding this unique phenomenon. Brihaspati, the teacher of gods, then revealed that sage Shukracharya was the teacher of the demons. This sage Shukracharya knew the Sanjeevini mantra, which brought dead demons to life. Upon hearing this, Kacha and all the gods were disappointed and completely demoralized, because they thus realized that there is no other way how to vanquish the demons if they are going to come back alive again and again due to the Sanjeevini mantra. Kacha, the handsome son of Brihaspati, who was the teacher of gods, now volunteered. In fact, he had an idea. He asked his father whether his father also knew the Sanjeevini mantra. Sage Brihaspati answered that he did not know the Sanjeevini mantra, and except Shukracharya, no one knows Sanjeevini mantra. Now Kacha, true to his nature, volunteered to go to Shukracharya, the demon teacher, as a student to learn the Sanjeevini mantra. Upon hearing this, the gods were apprehensive, because Kacha was their only teacher's son, and if at all his identity was revealed, the demons would definitely kill him, and they did not want this to happen. There was another reason why the gods were worried. The gods were worried that Kacha might fall in love with Devyani, the most beautiful daughter of Shukracharya, and lose his vision. Kacha was a very handsome prince, but then he was also virtuous. So, to convince and to appease all the gods, he made a vow that he would not fall in love with Devayani, however beautiful she was, and he in fact promised the gods that he would remain unmarried until his mission is fulfilled. Upon getting the consent from his father, Kacha went to Shukracharya and became his disciple. For many years, Shukracharya accepted Kacha as his favorite disciple and taught him everything except the Sanjeevini mantra. Kacha also waited patiently and served his guru with all his heart. Now Devyani, the beautiful daughter of Sage Shukracharya, was the apple of her father's eye. Whatever she wanted, the father always bestowed it to her. Kacha and Devyani became good friends. As Kacha was there in the ashram for a long time, they spent a lot of time together. Yet Kacha never got involved with Devyani, nor did he forget his vow. Once, when Kacha and Devyani were outside roaming in the garden, the demons spotted Kacha with Devyani. They did recognize him and they planned to kill Kacha right there. While Kacha was grazing cattle, They tried to push him from the mountain. This was the first attempt. In fact, the demons were not aware that they would find it very difficult to, in fact, kill Kacha for that matter. So in the first attempt, they pushed him from the mountain, and as a result, Kacha died. In the evening, Devayani waited anxiously for Kacha, and when she realized that he was not going to return, she implored her father to recite the Sanjivani mantra and to bring him back. Though initially apprehensive, Shukracharya didn't know any other way except to recite the mantra, or else his daughter would be heartbroken. So Shukracharya recited the mantra and brought Kacha back. Devayani was so happy, but the demons were disappointed. A few weeks later, the demon spotted Kacha once again. So one more attempt now. Now this would be the second attempt there. Now in the second attempt, the demons lifted Kacha and flung him far into the sea. In fact, they clapped while he drowned and died. Later in the other part, Devayani, after waiting for a long time, when she realized that Kacha was not going to come back, her fears had come true. She thought that maybe the demons had once again hurt Kacha and she was inconsolable. She forced her father to revive Kacha with the same Sanjivani mantra. Again, after Kacha came back to life, he was worried because the demons had tried twice before, once by air and by water, to kill him. So he was worried whether the demons would be successful in the third attempt. After some time, when Kacha was accosted by the demons, Kacha himself gave them an idea to kill him. Now this must be surprising. Why is Kacha giving an idea to kill him? Or why is he in fact helping the Asuras? But then Kacha was a very intelligent man. He had an idea up his sleeve. He told the demons that in spite of them trying to kill him, both the times they were not successful. So this time he asked the demons to burn him and feed his ashes to Shukracharya. In fact, the demons were convinced, and after killing him in the fire, they took his ashes and mixed his ashes with wine and fed it to their sage Shukracharya. Shukracharya was not aware of any of these happenings, and again on Devayani's insistence, he tried reciting the mantra. But this time Kacha did not appear. Devayani was inconsolable. In fact, she said Shukracharya got slightly irritated and he told her whether he wanted her father or Kacha, to which she told that without both of them she could not be alive. Now Shukracharya was perplexed. After some time, he heard Kacha's voice from inside his body. And then now Shukracharya didn't know what else to do. Then he at last came to the conclusion that he had to teach the mantra to Kacha, or else Kacha could not come out of his own body. Finally, Shukracharya had an idea. He taught Kacha the Sanjivani mantra. Kacha recited the mantra and he came out tearing the body of Shukracharya. But as promised to his teacher, he once again recited the mantra and revived his teacher Shukracharya. Now the mission was accomplished. Shukracharya was alive. For Devayani, both the men who mattered in her life were alive. But then Kacha got the secret for which he had waited for so many years. Once his mission was accomplished, Kacha left Shukracharya and a heartbroken Devayani, without breaking his vow, he returned to the gods and handed over the Sanjivani mantra. So that lesson is fairly simple, but it has a meaningful message. That is, to achieve a goal, focus is essential. So remember, in a nutshell, how Kacha got the secret. Sage Brihaspati was the teacher of gods or the Suras, and Sage Shukracharya was the teacher of demons or Asuras. Kacha, the son of Brihaspati, took a vow that he would not marry Devayani to procure Sanjivani mantra. Devayani, the beautiful daughter of Shukracharya, who in the end remains heartbroken. Kacha, quite intelligent, procures the Sanjivani mantra and returns to the gods. So always remember, focus is essential to attain any goal.